Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Today, I will be analyzing the company of Corsair Gaming, which trades in the Nasdaq under the ticker symbol CRSR. To be very honest, most probably you have already heard about this company because there are several other YouTubers talking about it. And actually, when I first heard about it, which was around December last year, that's when I first discovered the company, I was not actually too convinced about it, so I never invested in it, but the price of the stock has been dropping and dropping and dropping, and right now it has gotten to such a cheap valuation that it has been impossible for me not to have a second look at it and to finally end up investing in it. But before we start with the analysis, let me quickly share with you the main topics that I will be covering in today's video, so you kind of have some expectations on what this video is going to be about. So first of all, I will start with very quickly an introduction to the company, what is it that they do, some general metrics, followed by the industry and also the competitors. And actually, with one of these competitors, we will be comparing the financials of Corsair to those of Logitech, which is the main one that they have as competitor. After this, we will also look into the valuation of Corsair, and also we will do some very basic future price projections. And finally, as always, I will be giving my personal opinion on the company and my future plans with it. With that said though, and after I remind you that if you enjoyed the video, it would be super awesome if you could give it a like, and please also consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't done so already. But as I said, with that said, let's go for it. Corsair Gaming, as the name already suggests, operates within the gaming industry. And more concretely, what they do is that they develop and manufacture different equipment and technology for gamers, for PC lovers, and other content creators. And mostly they divide their products that they sell into different categories. On the one hand, we have the gamer and creator peripherals, which includes keyboards, mice, or for instance, headsets, amongst others. And then on the other hand, we have the gaming components and systems, which includes custom-built PCs, cooling solutions, among others. What is also interesting to know and talk about are its distribution channels, because of course they are using traditional methods like brick and mortar stores, mostly on the gaming space, of course, but they also use other online retailers like, for instance, Amazon or Best Buy. And of course, they also have the website and they also sell it directly through their own website. And here, I also want to point out that Amazon is not a competitor like some people could think of, but is actually just a partner, and they use it also to distribute and sell their products. Then moving into the industry, the estimations by Newzoo expect the market to shrink slightly in 2021 compared to 2020, but this is just because in 2020 the industry itself experienced massive growth due to the lockdowns, people being at home, and what we all know. However, in the long run, there is still interesting potential with an estimated compound annual growth rate between 2019 and 23 of 7.2%. And going into another study by ReportLinker, the global gaming market is expected to grow at a compound annual growth rate of 10.5% until 2026, reaching a value of $295.63 billion. These projected growth rates are pretty impressive, but what they are doing is just showcasing something that is happening all around us. I personally see it with my friends or the people I surround myself with, which is that more people are getting into the gaming industry. They are playing more games, of course, spending more time on that as entertainment, as opposed to maybe going and playing sports or doing other things, and also they are spending more money. And for instance, at the moment, there are more live viewers for very big events of championships of games, like for instance, League of Legends, than of certain retransmissions of traditional maybe sports, like football or other events. Next, let's talk about the competitors within the industry that they are in. And I'm already very sorry about the graph that I will show now in a little while in the screen, but unfortunately, I could not find any other with better quality. In it though, what we see is the leadership position of Corsair in different markets within the US, and in data from June of 2020, so last year, and that it was collected by NPD Group. For instance, in the case of keyboards, they held the number one spot, and then the other competitors also competing in that specific category include Logitech, Razer, or Kingston. Then for mice, for instance, they held the third spot, for gaming headsets, the fourth, streaming gear, the second, and so on. And what you see though is that they are in everything in the first four spots, at least in the US. Obviously, the company is shipping to many more countries and not just the US, but we cannot deny that the US is one of its main markets. And overall, we could summarize that Corsair has a more or less leading position within the first four spots, but it has a lot of competition, although I would highlight as main competitors the following companies, which are basically Logitech, as we mentioned, and the one that we will be comparing in a little while, Razer, Kingston, and Microsoft. Now, as I just mentioned, I will be comparing Corsair to Logitech because they are two very direct competitors. Of course, they have its differences, but also both of them are publicly traded. However, before we go into that, let me quickly go over the financials of Corsair Gaming. Firstly, in terms of revenues, you can see the incredible growth of more than 50% that the company had during the past year. For this year, 2021, they are expecting total revenues to range between $1.9 to $2.1 billion. And here I just placed the lower end of the estimations to try to be more conservative. And if this were to be the case, we would see a year-over-year growth of almost 12%. And then on the bottom line, this past year, 2020, was actually the first in which the company was profitable, with a net profit of $103 million. In the previous years, they reported losses, however, these were almost insignificant, and they were almost at that point where they were reaching profitability. Now, comparing these figures with those of Logitech, we see that Logitech is a bit more than two times larger in terms of revenues than Corsair. Also, they had massive increases in revenues during the past year, even at a higher rate than Corsair, actually standing at 76%. Switching to net incomes, Logitech is a profitable company and has been so for the past 3 years. Then, the net income margins of Logitech are also better than the ones of Corsair. And just this past year, while Corsair had a net income margin of 6%, Logitech had it of 18%, which is really, really good. Finally, the balance sheets of both look very good. In the case of Corsair, it has a conservative debt ratio of 61.57%, but that of Logitech is even better, with only a 40.62% debt ratio. Overall, we are looking at two companies doing very similar things, but of course Logitech, as we saw, is a bit more than two times larger than Corsair. And being a larger company also means that it is more consolidated, they are making better use of the economies of scale, and this usually also leads to higher net income margins, like it's precisely the case comparing Logitech to Corsair. In general, I would say that Logitech is what Corsair could aspire to be in around 5 to maybe 10 years' time. At this point of the video, before extending this comparison also to the valuation of both companies, I would first of all like to focus just on Corsair. And this one, if we look at the price of the stock at the moment of preparing this video, it stands at $26.40 per share. And taking this price, the amount of shares outstanding, which by the way, I took those from the latest financial statement as I trust it more than what it says in Yahoo Finance, as sometimes it's not exactly accurate. And also taking the sales for the past year and also the lower end of the forecasted ones for this 2021, we have a price to sales ratio for 2020 of 1.44 times sales and a forward price to sales ratio for 2021 of 1.29 times. If instead of the sales, we take the profits, we have a P/E ratio of 23.73 looking at the profits reported for the past year 2020 and a forward P/E ratio of 21.49 times based on what I'm expecting it to report during this year 2021, which if you are curious, it was just, or I just applied an increase of 10% from the net incomes that they reported this past year. All of these metrics of valuation are very low, especially considering that the average P/E ratio of the S&P 500 is currently of 35.04 times, and that I would expect Corsair to grow more than the average company in the S&P 500. But talking about growth, let's do some very basic price projections of the revenues of the company in a few years' time. For it, I forecasted basically two different scenarios. One scenario considers that from the lower end of the estimations of this 2021 sales, which were $1.9 billion, from that, they grow at 5% until 2025. So revenues just growing at 5%. And the other estimation is taking also the lower end of the estimations for this year, and then saying that Corsair will grow at 10% every single year from then until 2025. And I think that Corsair is likely to grow more than that, but I like to be very conservative in my estimations to kind of like have numbers or be safe whenever I'm then investing my money. Doing this, we would have that Corsair would be making anywhere from $2.31 billion to $2.78 billion in 2025, depending on the estimation. And taking these numbers, I then assumed a net income margin of 6% of that, which in my eyes is pretty conservative, and I would expect it to be higher as time goes by. And taking the profits, I made 6 different price projections, assuming 3 different P/E ratios in 2025. One of 25, one of 20, and the other one of 15. In the left column, I placed the estimations using the lower end of the net profit estimations that I calculated before, so $138 million. And on the right-hand side of the screen, you can see the higher end of this, so $166 million reported of net profits in 2025. With it, we have that in the worst-case scenario, the stock would be worth $22.40 per share, and in the best-case scenario, $44.97 per share. Honestly, I have been so conservative in everything that I'm pretty confident that the stock price will be about $50 per share, but I'd like to put the full scope of my estimations. At the end of the day, the biggest determinant of where the stock of Corsair will be in 4 years' time is just at how much they actually end up growing and at how much you think that they are able to grow. Personally, I think that they can maintain a growth rate of more than 10% during the next years, and especially considering that, as we saw earlier on, the industry itself is expected to grow at a compound annual growth rate of 10.5% already until 2026. So just if they grow as much as the industry itself, they should be doing more than all of the estimations that we have like showcased right now. Now that we have the full scope of the valuation of Corsair, we have done some price projections and so on, let's compare it with that of Logitech. And doing so, we see that while on a price to sales ratio, Corsair is cheaper, on a P ratio, Logitech is slightly cheaper. And the reason for that is that Logitech, as we saw, has much better net income margins, and that helps it a lot. However, at the same time, as it is larger, the growth potential is also more limited than with Corsair, although it hasn't been the past. During the past year, they grew even more than them, but I would expect it to grow at slower rates than Corsair. Overall, though, I must say that both companies are currently trading at attractive valuations. At this point of the video, it is time now for me to give my personal opinion on Corsair and also my future plans with it. In general, I must say that I don't expect Corsair to grow drastically, to have more than 20% growth, no, but I would expect it to easily continue growing at a bit more than 10% year over year during the next 5 to 10 years very, very easily, just because the market is growing and I would expect it to continue growing as time goes by. On the other hand, it is true that they are having some not so good aspects surrounding the operations of the business, which is that transportation costs have increased drastically. This is something that they pointed out in their latest earnings call, and this will affect their net income margins, at least in the short term, but I would expect this to get better as time goes by. And also something important that I did not mention is that they mostly have their facilities, so their factories are located in China, Taiwan, and the southeast of Asia. They don't own all of them. Some of them, it is just that they hire another factory to produce whatever they end up selling, but I think it's also worth noting. Currently, I own 44 shares at a cost basis of $26.97 per share, so basically $27 per share. And I must say that if it continues dropping like it has been during the past weeks, I will continue to add more to it gradually. It's a company that I feel very confident putting much more money inside, because I feel like the valuation is already too cheap, that it cannot go that much lower. Of course, everything can go lower, but if it goes lower, I will just continue adding more, as I feel like the valuation just doesn't make sense, especially when you're comparing it with the rest of the market, which has relatively high valuations if you compare it with the history of, for instance, the S&P 500. With that said, though, I want to remind everyone that I'm no financial advisor and that you should always do your own due diligence before investing in this or any stock, and that I, of course, take no responsibility whatsoever. With that said, though, this is the end of the video. What are your thoughts on Corsair Gaming, on the company? Will you be investing in its stock? Do you already perhaps own shares of the company? Please let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, then don't forget to give it a like. Subscribe to the channel if you are not yet subscribed. And as always, see you next time.